Distinguished members, distinguished friends, distinguished guests, it's a great pleasure to welcome you to the special connecting event of the ITI-UNESCO Network for Higher Education in the Performing Arts. It's obvious that the pandemic is not yet over. It is sorrow that I have become aware that many performances again cannot happen or are postponed, and that face-to-face education is limited again. The performing arts community once more is suffering, and that concerns the education and stage skill as well. It looks like a black cloud is covering the performing arts world, its creators, its educators, its contributors, its participants. Where is the freedom to perform? The freedom to educate? Where is joy and interest of a person in the audience? In this situation, I ask myself, what can the ITI-UNESCO Network for Higher Education in the Performing Arts do? What should this network offer to overcome the barriers that the authorities and even common sense is imposing on all of us? How can this global network help its member institution to be connected with the world when its members often are bound to work on a local level? How can we increase the awareness of cultural diversity in education that exists on a global level? How can we do an essential step towards a better future for the education in the performing arts now? One of the answers is that we should use our communication skills and help to unite the members and friends of the ITI-UNESCO network. That is why we started to get in touch with our members and with outstanding artists, did a survey on themes that are of interest, and finally conceived this special connecting event online. During the development, the event has become a joint initiative of the General Secretariat, the board, and the members of the ITI-UNESCO network, and also the selected four artists and many more people who are involved in this initiative. We call it the connecting event, as the goal is to bring members and friends in communication with each other and to stimulate the work that has been done so far and inspire collaboration for the future. Who is behind each of the member institutions? What are the activities of the member institutions? How do outstanding artists work in these difficult times? What burning, substantial topics need to be developed as a project in the future? These and other issues will be touched during the special connecting event that have been developed under the guidance of the General Secretariat of the ITI-UNESCO Network and ITI Worldwide. I'm inviting you to participate or watch, and above all, to communicate with each other, communicate to the General Secretariat and be part of this movement that consists of people and institutions that are dedicated to education in the performing arts and that are following the goals of mutual understanding and peace of UNESCO and the International Theatre Institute, ITI. And mutual understanding and peace is continuously extremely important for creating a world that is rich in culture, rich in the diverse education in the performing arts. Thank you for being here. Thank you for your interest so far. I hope you appreciate what the General Secretariat and the members of the ITI-UNESCO Network for Higher Education in the Performing Arts and the artists are presenting to you.